7. That is the week of January the 4th, January 10th in college basketball. And here we are. Conference play is starting up and starting to grind is here of a conference schedule, and everything is looking very interesting now. Now that we know a lot more than what we did 7 weeks ago. And honestly, you know, there are teams that are moving around, teams that should be in the top 25, teams that should be in the top 5, that should be in the top 5, and teams that should not be in the top 25 at all. First off, for West Virginia, Oscar Tshiebwe, he is gone. He's sitting out the season for personal reasons. Miami, for some odd reason, has looked at him. I know that for sure because I had seen something yesterday or the day before that about Tshiebwe being gone. And I was like, wait, what? What in the world? He left? And, you know, I was just like, okay, let me see what's going on here. You know, let's check this out. And West Virginia has fallen in the rankings after that loss to Oklahoma. They take on Oklahoma State tonight. Not going to watch that. Not really interested in watching that game, but it is there. Cade Cunningham and company, you know, can they overcome that press? And speaking of a team that could overcome that press, later on this week, on Saturday, my Longhorns will take on West Virginia, who, the Longhorns are now ranked number 4 in the nation, and you know the guys. I've already talked about the guys on the team. You know, Matt Coleman, Kai Jones, you know, Jericho Sims, the works. Texas is a damn good team this year. I have been very surprised by this team. And, you know, we take on Iowa State tomorrow. And, I mean, it's just been a blast to watch this team play this year. And, you know, I've never been more excited. As far as the rest of the Big 12 goes, Kansas is taking on TCU. Also tomorrow, and Texas Tech will also fall a little bit, takes on Kansas State. Clemson, surprisingly enough, has moved into the top 25, and very surprised there. I mean, I have no idea what in the world Clemson does or anything like that, but they're in the top 25. As far as Michigan State goes, I don't think they deserve to be in the top 25. Like, they have been losing a lot of games lately. They've lost 3 straight in conference. It's been a rough, rough go for them. And I don't know what's going on. They take on Rutgers tomorrow. I might watch that. I might not. It depends. But, you know, Rutgers is a good team. Ron Harper Jr. and company should have some fun in East Lansing. You know, there's also Minnesota, Michigan. Now, finally, if I can take the time out of the day on Wednesday, I'll be able to see this game because Michigan and Minnesota, these are two programs that are, you know, they have looked good, and I mean, they've looked good and everything like that. Michigan, you know, they haven't had a lot to say about them. You know, now's the time. Minnesota, too. Haven't had a lot to say about them, but now is the time. And St. Louis is also shown up in the top 25. They are going to take on LaSalle on Wednesday. It'll be an early afternoon game for some reason, but whatever. You know, there's that. And then Baylor is taking on Oklahoma on Wednesday night. Be careful out there, Baylor. They did upset West Virginia last week. Careful. As far as Gonzaga goes, they are taking on Santa Clara on Thursday night, and Oregon is taking on Colorado. Now, are the voters paying attention to the West Coast aside from Oregon and Gonzaga? I don't think so, because there are some teams that look very interesting out in the West Coast, but, you know, again, hasn't been really a following for, you know, what in the world's been going on out in the West Coast. It's been a rough year for the Pac-12 already, you know, not just in football, but in basketball too, and, you know, things not looking the same. There's a couple of games on Friday night. I'm very surprised about that. But we don't know what the times are going to be for these Saturday games. Obviously, Texas, West Virginia is the biggest game on Saturday. And there are some games that got moved around thanks to the NFL, like Oklahoma, Kansas. That's going to be early, you know, 12:30. And then Minnesota, Iowa, that's also going to be big, you know, on Sunday. I might watch that. I might try. So Minnesota has a big opportunity this week to prove themselves, you know, against Iowa and against Michigan. If they could do that, you know, because, I mean, the Big Ten has been the gauntlet this year. I mean, I've said this the last 3 or 4 weeks that the Big Ten has just been that damn good. It's been a pretty damn good conference this year. And Minnesota, they went 2-1 last week against great Big Ten teams. Can they go 2-0 this week? We'll find it out. We'll find it out shortly. And there's not a lot of ranked versus ranked matchups. Once again, there are, of course, there's going to be some games that are going to be completely under the radar that are going to be damn good as well. But there's just not a lot here. Like Wake Forest is taking on Duke. Like, I haven't seen the Wake Forest game at all this year. It's been very top heavy, like it usually is in college basketball, which is like 40 different teams fighting for a championship instead of like 4 in college football. But we're not going to talk about that right now. Just because Ohio State is unranked now does not mean anything. You know, Rutgers, they'll have to grind it out with Ohio State, because Ohio State is a damn good team themselves. Seen them play already. I think Kansas, the most important thing for them is just to keep going through the rest of the slate, wait for the big time teams to, you know, get there. They already beat up on West Virginia early in the season. They'll get another chance to beat up on West Virginia. I don't think they played Baylor yet, and they've obviously lost to Texas. So, you know, I don't know about Texas Tech yet either, but 3 of the top 6 are Big 12 teams, so it just speaks also to how much I've been focusing on these two conferences, the Big 10 and the Big 12. Tennessee and Missouri, I know they're ranked, but I mean, there's just nothing really I can say there. I mean, I've been able to watch these two teams play, and then, you know, things got out of hand last week. I was supposed to watch them, but I ended up not watching them play at all. So, you know, the focus has been primarily on the Big 10 and the Big 12. I think there's a little bit of ACC love in there too, but I mean, the ACC, you know, they haven't looked as good as they were in the past. North Carolina isn't even near these rankings. Like, it's been that kind of year, and the SEC hasn't been near these kind of rankings because Kentucky's so bad. And, it's just rough. But I'm glad there's a new team in St. Louis in the top 25. They also take on St. Joe's on Saturday as well. Florida State, I really don't see why they're in right now. Virginia, don't see why they're in right now either. Duke has been kind of rough to watch. Clemson is a completely out of nowhere type pick to put in the top 25. I mean, they're just kind of there. You know, and of course, there's still two Big East teams, you know, Villanova and Creighton. But I mean, Villanova's been ravaged by COVID, and Creighton, they've just been quietly moving along. They're number 7 in the country right now. So, you know, things are looking interesting. Houston's still ranked 2. They're ranked outside the top 10, though. But they have a chance to get back into it if some things going their way. You know, but Houston's still a good team. They got caught off guard last week. Know, and everything like that. So, again, see you guys later to talk, you know, about NFL and stuff like that. So, y'all take care, have a good day, and again, see you soon.